M1 Global presents.
Представляем вашему вниманию трехраундовый бой в среднем весе. В синем углу рейджа спортсмен из Украины. Встречайте, Вячеслав Богомол по прозвищу Бизон.
Ой, за гори, за туману, там, де вітер вже не спить, ідуть в полі отамани, земля ходить та й дрижить. Ой, за гори, за туману, там, де вітер вже не спить.
Вячеслав Богомол, Україна!
За туману, там, де вітер вже не спить.
Делам тут каждый брат достойный. Казаки идут за победой, с родовой от воина. Деда, береги башку, впереди нас ждут все остальные следом. Сколько героев, перебитых в ринге. Чё-то кричал там парень, сейчас летят ботинки. Молюсь за каждого бойца, верю я в творца. Если вышел драться, то лирить, кусайся до конца. Левый, правый, по лапам раз. Накидал мне слабо место, сабли в рюкзаки. Пинты, шорты, перчатки, капа. После Мухаммеда Али, выйти на Олимп.
Украинский атаман,
а не школа Шали. Слушай, брат, победу не дают тут по талонам. Выходит сборная бойцов, сборная чемпионов. Ведь сила, уверенность, великий дух и дисциплина. Когда в канатах парни с надписью Украина.
Ой, за гори, за туману, там, где лидер уже не спит. Идут в поле, атаманы, земля ходит, дай дышит.
Спортсмен в красном углу рейджа представляет Российскую Федерацию. Город-герой Москва. Встречайте, русский молот в красном углу. Валерий Мясников! Итак, господа, трехраундовый бой в среднем весе. Представляю вам спортсменов. Спортсмен в синем углу. Ему 24 года, вес 83,3 килограмма, рост 180 сантиметров. Профессиональный рекорд. 8 побед, всего одно поражение. Он чемпион Украины по смешанным боевым единоборствам по версии World Cossacks Fight Federation. Чемпион мира по смешанным боевым единоборствам по версии WMMAF. Представляет клуб Бронебор Тим из Украины. Вячеслав Богомол по прозвищу Бизон в синем углу. И его соперник в красном углу рейджа. 24 года, вес 84 килограмма ровно, рост 185 сантиметров, профессиональный рекорд. 9 побед, 1 поражение, 1 ничья. Мастер спорта по боксу, мастер спорта по рукопашному бою, победитель международных турниров по боксу, победитель спартакиады МВД России по рукопашному бою, представляет клуб единоборств номер 1 и команду Industrials, город Москва, Россия, Валерий Русский Молот Мясников в красном углу. Рефери в ринге Марко Броверсон, королевство Нидерланды.
Red corner, blue corner. You both know the rules. Listen to my command. Protect yourself all the time. Make it a good match. Shake hands. Step back to your corner.
Step back to your corner. Step back, step back, step back, step back. Judge. 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 Time ready. Fight is ready. Fight!
Here we go, ladies and gentlemen. Fourth fight of the evening. In the blue corner, Vyacheslav Bogomol. In the red corner, Valery Mesnikov.
Well, Bogomol steered for the clinch. Went for a takedown. Nice tie clinch there. Knees to the head. Mesnikov wants to break free. Wants to strike. Definitely got the better striking of the two, you can tell that straight away.
Certainly does.
Nice low kick there coming from Bogomol.
Bogomol targeting that front leg, which looks like it could have carried some sort of injury.
Yeah, straight away going for that knee. He's marked up already as Bogomol.
Mesnikov's patient, trying to find his range. The former M1 Global light heavyweight title challenger, actually.
Oh, nice shot to the body.
His striking is much improved since those days back in 2014. Back then he came up against Stefan Putz and came up short, lost via TKO.
To be honest, there's not many people actually win Stefan Putz. Coming up short is there's no mean defeat, really.
Certainly isn't.
But there you go, breaking free again. Mesnikov's stones come out of the thumb hole. Back to normal, let's go. He's just picking him off.
Found his range so quickly in this fight. Very impressive. Really sharp so far. This is the best I've seen Mesnikov, and I've called all three of the fights, all three of his most recent fights.
Yeah, Bogomol knows he's a little bit more tentative now. Oh, nice shot to the body. That doubled him over there. Working well in the clinch though, Bogomol. Nice knee. Looks like blood coming from the nose with Mesnikov. It's the knees that's doing it. Again, chopping away. That front leg, you can see it's taped underneath the knee wrap. Oh, big right hand.
Perfect straight right, right down the center.
Well, one of the counters to a low kick is a straight right hand. Well, not really juggling it, God.
Mesnikov hasn't won a fight in 14 months, you can tell. He is feeling it tonight.
He wants this one.
Feeling it tonight, 100%. He has a 9-1 record.
Oh, thunderous shot. You can hear them right above our commentary box. And this is better ground and pound. See how he's posturing up. He's sitting back on his heels. There's an armbar attempt there. The elbow's free. Should he pull the elbow free, the armbar's not going to go on.
Should be noted, Bogomol is quite well-rounded. He has 4 wins by submission and 4 wins by KO. Quite capable in both styles.
Again, trying to secure arm Bogomol. You can see what he's working for. There you go. gets the hip round, but you can see the elbows past the groin area. Once the elbows past the groin, it's not even possible to put the arm bar on.
Has to go up to stand up.
Oh!
Back down, what a punch! Trying to mount. Gives up later on.
Well, great work by Bogomol to stop him getting the mount. Just kept on turning. Oh, big hammer fist, that was a thunderous shot. To be honest, you've got to give credit to Bogomol for staying in there.
He's eating some vicious shots so far. 30 seconds to go in the opening round. Bogomol's not going away quietly.
Oh, look at that. Umapala, he's got to sit forward. This is a shoulder lock. This could be on. This is very tight. Great work by Bogomol.
Very impressive.
Well, the only chance he has is to roll, but it could be too late. Oh, wow, how is he not tapping? The angle is slightly off position there, though. He's turned more over to his side. Saved by the bell.
Survived the round somehow. I wonder what shape his shoulder's in after that.
It's very hard to pull off at Umapala in MMA. BJJ, you've got the gi you can hang on to, you can hang on to the belt, you can pull them back by the gi.
You've got all sorts of friction you can work with in that regard. It's easier definitely with a gi on. And I mean, you don't factor in that they're sweating, they're tired, they're exhausted at this point. It just doesn't work that easily. The fact that he got that far into that position.
It was nearly on. It was nigh on perfect up until the point where he rolled forward, and when he rolled forward, he accidentally made him turn to his side, which put the submission off. Well, now, Masterkov knows what the submissions are like by Bogomol, so I don't think he'll want to go to the ground. He knows he can drop him with his punches. His striking is more clinical. I'd be very surprised if he goes down to the canvas now.
Certainly, you saw him eager before, but now he's going to be a lot more cautious. He knows this fight could be his. He cannot allow for small openings and weaknesses like that. It looks like Bogomol's definitely gone some confidence after that last 30 seconds of the first round.
Nice, his low kicks again. Not sure what effect they have on an injury. Yeah, Masnikov definitely wants to strike. The thumb again coming out of the glove. I only surmise he has a pair of gloves on that's a size too big for him. Nice left hook, but retaliated by Bogomol. Like I say, Bogomol's got knockouts to his record, although he doesn't look the better striker. He still has the power and he gets a takedown.
This is exactly where he wants to be now.
And there's the posture we were talking about. Sit back on your heels. But there's an armbar attempt of his own. The crowd are going crazy, but the arm is safe. Oh, big shots. Payback time.
A lot of body shots, too. I'm very impressed with that. Shots to the rib, shots to the midsection. I'm enjoying that a lot.
Gonna sweep him. He gets it. You can see that coming. He's in mount position now. Bogomol is in a bad position here, especially when we know the power Yasnikov has got.
I just wonder how much energy he has left, or he expended most of it in the first round.
Well, he's got both hooks in, he's flattened him out. That's exactly what he should do. Flatten your opponent so they can't move. Hard to see from this position whether he's under the chin or not.
Bogomol hasn't tapped yet. You can see both his hands there. Yasnikov let go of the submission. Looks like he's trying again.
It's under, he taps, it's over.
And Mistnikov's winless 14 months come to an end to his relief. The spot on the M1 roster is safe.
Well, credit to Bogomol, he put up a great fight. Striking wasn't as clinical, but the groundwork was great. Reversals were good, the ground and pound was good, but the submission defense from the rear mount, just not there.
Та не шляпа ти, блядь. Ти, блядь, дурачок мой любимый.
21 мне.
21.
21 год.
Уважаемые поклонники смешанных боевых единоборств, на третьей минуте второго раунда удушающим приемом победу одержал русский молот из Москвы Валерий Мясников! Клуб единоборств номер один и команда Industrials Москва, Россия! Валер, наше поздравление, что скажешь?
Ничего не скажу, хочу отметить. Спасибо всем. С Богом.
То есть этот бой оказался для тебя легкой пробежкой, что ли?
Да нет. Я ожидал, думал, будет легче, но пришлось попотеть. Такова работа.
Хорошо, попей водички. Валерий Мясников, Москва!